Hey everyone, welcome back. We are here with another tier list. These have started to become really popular on the channel, so we're going to keep doing it. And keeping with all the great Japanese wrestling we have been watching in the last few months, I guess, pretty much since the beginning of the year, New Japan, All Japan, Noah, they can do no wrong. Stardom, we decided
DDT.
To tier list. Yes, DDT Pro, Joshi
Dragon
Pro.
Gate.
Yes. We decided to tier list the current New Japan belts with the two greatest old school belts that they have. Needless to say, you know where I'm going to put those. So without any further ado, we're going to head right into the tier list to tier list the New Japan belts. So here we have the belts. There's not that many. For those who are not familiar, this is the New Japan Strong Heavyweight Champ, Open Weight Champion.
We'll go through it as we go.
Okay.
We'll go through it as we go.
And I guess we'll talk who the current champions are as well.
Yeah, you will. I don't know who anybody is.
You
I
know who all
this.
Of them are.
Never watched this before.
You never what watched this before. Okay. So the first belt is New Japan Strong. It is the current open weight champion is Kenta, who just won it not that long ago.
Strong, if you don't know, is the American version of New Japan Pro Wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
And that is their main title. My issue with it is, and it comes into play mostly with the other belts, is New Japan has a very specific type of idea when they make titles. They're massive. They're very big, thick belts. And AEW takes from that. And I think I really like that styling of belt. Where like WWE and Impact have like the American style where it's a lot like smaller, thinner plates.
Yeah.
I don't like how I don't like the faceplate on this, and I hate how floppy the belt is. Like
it's
feels
a little
really,
too the faceplate is a little too bland.
It feels
the
like a
strap
really
is
small
black
belt.
Or is it a dark blue?
I think it's black.
Okay.
At least now it is.
Yeah.
Well, I will say I do like the rounder belts anyway, though. I mean, there's not really anything popping on this outside of it being round. So round is the only thing I would say that would give me the benefit of liking this belt.
Yeah.
So.
I wouldn't D it, but I think it's a C.
Yeah. This is almost not as bad, but it's akin to the WWE Network logo belt. It's just the company logo right in the middle.
Yeah, which we have another one of those coming up. But
yes.
I think it's a C. It's not the ugliest belt I've ever seen, but it's not good.
Yeah.
It exists.
This has now long since been retired. This was the previous IWGP World Heavyweight Championship belt. Clearly, you could see the influence on AEW that it had on the AEW Championship with this one.
Yeah, it looks pretty much like it.
Yeah.
It is an iconic belt, and you're going to not like me in the end of this. But I think this is one of those belts that people talk about because it weighs like 40 pounds. Like, it's an absolute...
It's 17
like,
pounds. It's heavy.
They're like monster belts.
Yeah.
But I don't really like this one as much as everyone else does. I would say this is an A.
I'm kind of with you there.
The black takes away from it. The black and gold just doesn't work for me.
I don't know. The problem is, I feel like the black is like, you know how with some belts it has more of like a not like grayish tint, but like when they're going for that black, it has that very diluted. This has way, it looks way too dark. And the gold.
That's a good point. That's actually a really good point.
And then the plate itself is way too dark itself. It doesn't have the bright color. So if you look at the other ones that have that very dark texture to it, the gold is very much more brighter, has more of a yellow.
This is more of a dull, like a subdued.
Like copper. It's like a copper look. It's like
it
a copper
shine.
On black and it doesn't look.
And if you've seen it in its later days, it's really hard to even like make out the front of the plate, because it's all like faded and the color of it is so dark. It's like a brown almost.
Yeah.
I mean, it's still a really nice belt. Okay. We're just coming up with reasons for this tier list.
There we go. I agree with that. Next, we have the retired IWGP Intercontinental Championship. This was made famous, I guess, mostly by Shinsuke Nakamura
and Naito
and Tetsuya Naito. He was Tetsuya Naito was the one who merged the two belts.
Now, you guys can agree or disagree with me on this or not, but when it comes to that, like, copper gold that they do, that works way better in white, I think.
Yeah.
I think this actually looks better than it does in the black.
Yeah.
So I feel like this is
This was always my favorite belt.
This is probably my favorite belt of all time in the history of belts.
So we know where it goes.
Yeah, I'm down.
It's so iconic because, I mean, there's lots of people that are synonymous in this division, but this is primarily known as the place where Nakamura and Naito made their name. They both wanted to stay just in the Intercontinental Division.
Yeah.
And make their name there. I mean, do you know any of the history of that belt? Like, I'm not trying to put you on the spot there, but like,
not
has it
lot.
Been around?
It was around for, I think, since the 80s.
So is this why WWE made their belt white?
No. They made the belt white afterwards.
So they took the idea.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. I believe WWE had the belt white first, and then in the 90s, they moved to the white belt.
Okay. Yeah, that's a wonderful belt. I love it.
Yeah. It's definitely my favorite. When I saw back in 2014 or 15, Ring of Honor was here in Toronto with a co-branded New Japan show. Nakamura was the champ, and like, I got to see that belt firsthand, and it's absolutely gorgeous. So
beautiful
in the flesh. Next, we have
not so much like that one, which you can't really see right now.
Next, we have the IWGP Junior Heavyweight Championship.
Okay,
it's essentially the same belt on more of a silver nickel type of color.
Okay,
and it's a smaller belt,
and it's much smaller.
I want to just jump in and say this. I'm not familiar with that much with this belt, but as soon as I saw that picture, the first thing I thought about was the back in the 90s, the little rubber belts that you would get for your wrestling figures that had like that great. This looks so much like one of those rubber belts that you'd have one of those figures. It just looks just like it.
Yeah,
like
it's much smaller than the heavyweight championship.
It's reminiscent of the old school times of Japanese belts when they were all small.
Yes.
All of the old Japanese belts were very small. They were like the 1950s wrestling belts in the States, where they were those little tiny like ribbon belts.
And that's why this is the junior heavyweight, because it's not as big as the heavyweights.
And that's why it looked like those
80s. I think it looks better than the gold.
Really?
I think the all silver looks better than the gold.
I agree. If you're talking
current
about the
champion is Hiromu Takahashi. He still has this belt. And he is the current champion. So you would put this ahead.
We're in
of...
February 2023, just so everybody knows.
Yeah, I would put in that one. Yeah.
I would put it above there.
Yeah. Like that.
There's a reason they kept it still.
Yeah, I agree. I can agree with that as well. Next, we have, you can tell by the color once again, the IWGP Junior Tag Team Championship belts.
Actually, as of
the recording of this video, the current champions are Catch 2-2, Francesco Akira, and TJP.
So spoiler alert, I feel opposite about these belts than of the ones that we just talked about.
Mm-hmm.
I prefer the gold. I know we're not there yet, but the silver looks fine.
Yeah.
I would give the silver a B.
And these are slightly smaller than the heavyweight belts.
The plates
as well.
Are very thin compared to the other belts.
I kind of agree with that. It's a very simple belt, but it tells you what it is, and it's in the middle of the pack.
Yeah,
I'm good with that.
That's exactly how I'm feeling. I do feel the gold, but based on this image, the gold looks better. I don't know the comparatively, like actually seeing it. I don't know what it is.
I can tell you what it is. The text in black over here makes it pop more.
Either way,
I think it looks like a coin. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I know the silver does too, but it's like, okay, you know what? This made me think about this right now. We're talking about how they kind of took the idea for the Intercontinental belt from WWE. WWE's new tag team belts are a perfect carbon copy.
Well, remember
of these.
When the tag team belts were that copper? They looked like the big penny.
Yeah.
When they were on the black strap with the
A similar style.
Yeah.
And they're different color belts for each show, which this is black and black, I know, but the different color plates.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like this one better. The black writing, the IWGP stands out more. And in case anybody doesn't know, IWGP stands for International Wrestling Grand Prix Champion. They don't use NJPW as their branding.
We found out that like none of them do.
Yeah.
Right. Because GHC is Pro Wrestling Noah.
Yeah.
Which, what does that stand for? I remember I liked
Global
it.
Honored Crown.
Global Honored Crown. This, yeah. I would put this ahead, just right directly ahead of the silver ones.
I'll put that one, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm good with that too. Next, we have the NWGP US.
NWGP.
NWJ, New Japan Pro Wrestling, NJPW. I'm getting my alliteration confused. The United States Heavyweight Championship, currently, as of this recording, it's being held by Kenny Omega.
I really like the look of this belt. I've always liked the whole thing when they do the whole, you know, the US, like the whole colorations. It really pops on the belt in my eyes. So
I think
it's reminiscent of that old school WCW US championship belt.
Exactly. The red leather, the gold, the silver, the American flag, the black on it. And I just want to point out, like, I never really noticed it until recently, how absolutely massive this belt is. Like, it's huge. Side plates are gigantic.
It's actually bigger than the current IWGP World Heavyweight Championship belt.
I'm, want my honest opinion, I think it has to be A. I don't know where you put it in A, but it has to be A.
I would actually go above
and right behind
I agree.
Okay. I'm not going to be upset about that.
I kind of like it. These are
some people are going to yell at us about that. Yell at us in the comments.
Yeah, yell at us in the comments. Absolutely. We can take it. Next, we have the IWGP Women's Championship, introduced back in December at a Stardom event. And the current champion, as of this recording, is Mercedes Moné.
I kind of wish, like, seeing this now, that we had the old school IWGP belt, but it's basically the same thing.
Now, here's the funny thing. I'm looking at this, and when I look at it, I like the look of the whole crown look on top. It's something different when it comes to a belt. But what's really funny is the part where it has, like, the planet on it, I think, and it looks kind of like it has wings. It reminds me of the logo from the Street Fighter movie. So I feel like it's a combination of that with the crown.
Yeah, I never thought of that.
So it makes me think of that. So actually, this gives me a high A just because I like that.
I mean,
that.
This harkens back to the Riki Chozu days. This is, like, Masahiro Chono. This
very,
is
very thin strap. Like,
it's small. It's very tiny. And I think it was the right idea to bring it back as the women's design.
Yeah.
Because it has a nostalgia to it. It's a pretty cool belt.
Yeah, I kind of like it.
I don't like, but I'm going to take points away for how small it is.
Yes, and a little bit for the red lettering. I don't like the red lettering.
It's also, it's really small. Like, super small.
Yeah.
It's like a ribbon belt. Let's just put it this way.
Mercedes Moné, the current champion, is very small, and the belt still looks small on her.
Yeah, well, and Kairi was smaller, and the belt still looks small on her. So I'm going to say, for nostalgia reasons, it's the last belt in A.
Okay.
I can take that.
Yeah, I think so. Next, we have the current IWGP World Heavyweight Championship belt, currently held by Kazuchika Okada at the time of this recording.
So because it directly gives me in my brain thoughts of Okada, it's got to be at the top of C. I hate this belt. I hate it so much.
It's associated with Okada. There's no history to it right now.
It looks
either.
So stupid. I hate it.
Doesn't look at it again. Now, imagine it having pink. It looks a lot like the Divas belt.
You're right. It does. Whoa. The butterfly belt.
Whoa, Putty. Come on. That's enough. It's enough fun of you for one day. I don't like this belt.
Yeah, I don't either.
Am I wrong? Doesn't it look?
No, you're not wrong at all. I don't like it either.
The massive size of it makes it better than, I think, the strong belt.
Yeah. But it's still in the C category.
I'm not a fan of it. I hate the design of it.
Yeah, and now that Putty mentioned that it's the Divas belt, I can't unsee it.
Yeah, see it. No, as soon as I saw it, I said that looks like the Divas
belt. But this belt,
put the pink in there.
I gotta be right. This one's like 35 pounds, isn't it? Isn't this like the heaviest belt in wrestling?
I think so. I think it weighs slightly more than the NWA Heavyweight Championship.
That plate is thick.
Yeah,
when you see it from the side, it's huge.
On average, the average plate is about 2 to 4 or 5 millimeters. I think this is 6 or 7 millimeters thick because it's layered.
Hold on, I'm Googling.
You're Googling it.
Might as well go look up the Divas belt, see if they have the same.
All right, you can talk about the next one.
Yeah. Next is we're going to end this poorly because we have the never open weight six man tag team belts currently held by Minoru Suzuki, Desperado, El Desperado, and what's his name? Ren Narita.
Oh, good win for Ren Narita, though. Can we talk about putting someone over? Suzuki came in and did right by him.
Yeah.
These are D.
Yeah. But it's still a D belt. Yeah.
No one had to even let you finish talking.
I love how this came into an optimistic thing. It was like,
it's an ugly belt. It is. It's not.
I get it. But I just loved his way of going into that. That it was just amazing and it was funny.
No,
so,
I mean, obviously, Ren Narita needs a belt. And it was good for Minoru Suzuki to put him over, but it's still an ugly belt.
It's got to be one of the uglier belts in all of mainstream wrestling.
Yeah,
well, I can't find the weight, by the way. I'm not that familiar with it, but like the way it looks with the white, I'm guessing that's a blue, the planet Earth and the blue in the middle. Like there's so much going on there. And I'm like,
but
what
the thing is, like, don't
at?
Let the plate and it's like kind of detail fool you because they're so thin and the belts are so plain. It's just like,
it's like, I never want to carry this belt.
Yeah, no. Oh, it only gets worse from here.
Yes. Next we have the Nestle Crunch Bar of Soap New Japan TV Championship. Currently
the New Japan
time...
World TV title. You made a belt named after the website.
Well, WWE has a network belt too with the logo on the front.
Yeah, it's like a digital media championship.
Yeah. But at least that one looks kind of nice.
Yeah, this is bottom D for me. It looks horrible.
Yeah, it looks like a Nestle Crunch Bar had a baby with a bar of soap.
But like, it looks like it's a knockoff version of Willy Wonka the Chocolate Factory. So the golden
ticket.
My one credit that I will give to it is it's freaking huge.
Yes, current champion as of this recording is Zack Sabre Jr.
Worthy champion, the right choice.
The right
great intro music.
Went over Ren Narita, actually, funny enough, in that match.
Hey, people over.
Talk about putting people over, but I think it still belongs there.
Yeah.
I know you need to do introductions. I'm just going to say this. I think Stockholm Syndrome has kicked in because you know I love the color blue, and I'm looking at this belt, and I know it's hideous, but for some reason, I'm like, it's not that bad to me.
I'll make a fair agreement with you later on, but at this point, this I hate.
I think that's
belts.
What's happened.
Current champions right now, it's the NJPW Strong Tag Team Champion.
But compared
it's
to other blue
currently
belts,
held by the Motor City Machine Guns at the time of this recording.
Great team.
But as a fan of the color blue, which I'm sure there's other people, I'm just saying the color blue, using the silver with the blue actually does make it pop a little more than
does.
The other one.
It actually looks like
it works.
Better than
but can we
it
make an
better...
agreement? Can we have an agreement?
Sure.
Can we drop the strong belt down to D and put these in that spot?
Well, could I have that
one
maybe at bottom B? Because I actually kind of like it. Could put that bottom B possibly or my or drop C? Because it's still uglier than the Divas belt in my eyes. Or prettier than the Divas belt in my eyes.
What do you think, JD? Okay. You make this call.
I, funny enough, I do kind of like this belt better than the current heavyweight championship.
All right. Then I think that's fair.
I'm okay with that. This can go in D.
This one is it's not even really a championship. It is the KOPW Provisional Champion. Currently held by Shingo Takagi. This is basically a year-long belt, I guess. You win it at whoever wins it at the beginning of the year.
Whoever has it at the very end of the year is the champion.
Is the king of pro wrestling, exactly. He's labeled the champion. But now
I
there's
like
a belt
the
for
idea.
It.
I like the idea, don't get me wrong, but we need another better belt for this, and this one goes and done.
Well, let me just explain this to you, right? Like visually. It's absolutely massive, like the TV title. It's huge, but it doesn't feel like a leather belt. It feels like it's made out of a thick fabric.
Synthetic leather, yeah.
And it's powder blue, and I kind of don't hate it that much.
Really? The
I kind of don't
so
hate
ugly.
It that much.
The only thing I want to take away from it, and
it's
I noticed
so ugly,
this trend.
It's nice.
I've noticed this trend in belts, and now New Japan is going with it as well, is they've gotten rid of the buckles and started adding Velcro.
Yeah.
I guess it's easier
and
quicker to put
the Velcro.
Which adds to the fabric-y look of it, right?
Yeah, and that's
what
makes it.
They don't look like leather. They look like they're made out of, like, it's wrapped in cloth.
Yeah, so basically this belt have Velcro straps instead of the buckles. But they don't hide that. In WWE, they hide the fact that it's Velcro because they put the little rivets in the back, but there's no rivets.
I never knew about that. Wow.
And the belts are black. One of these belts is brown and the other one is blue. So you could see the Velcro.
Yes.
I don't hate this. Come on. This is not the worst belt.
No, yeah, it's not.
But I still feel the strong belt. Better.
You want to put it at the top of D?
I would say at the bottom of C, but that. Let's see what Putty says.
No, I can do that. As long as it doesn't beat the other blue. That blue is hideous looking. The other blue looks better with the silver, honestly.
You know what? I don't want to be this guy, but the never open weight trios titles are better than the strong.
Really?
I don't know if I agree with that, but okay.
But you want to know something we're missing about?
Which one?
The never open weight title. Which just looks exactly like the trios title, so it doesn't really matter.
It's basically the same belt.
It is the exact same belt.
It is, yeah. But yeah, and that's currently held by Hikaleo at the time of this recording. But it looks exactly the same. You are correct.
There's such an odd, like, warm feeling of the way this looks because it's such a small tier list, but there's so an even block going down a path outside of, like, B, just needing one more there just to fit that slot. You know what I mean? Like, it just looks so even and fair.
But see, if we did have the never open weight championship, it would throw everything off with 4 and D.
Yeah, exactly. So
yeah,
That's it. We'll keep this list short. Let us know in the comments below if you agree with that. It's safe to say we all agree on this one. People may not agree with this one, but then again, it's my video.
People are definitely not going to agree with the one directly under that one, but I mean,
this holds a lot of nostalgia.
Again, you look, nice pennies you got right there, brother. Nice gluing the pennies on a strap because that's what it looks like. You look like you took a big penny and just glued it right on there.
Hey, my Naito figure has that around his waist. So
this one?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, the white belt is, you could see it on the side.
If you're going to force any kind of forced copper, they did it better here. They did it better here when it comes to that forced copper look. And that's still brighter, but you know what I mean.
There we go. Anyway, so that's the list. Like I said, let us know what your thoughts are down below. If there's another list you guys want to see in terms of belts, let us know that in the comments below as well. And with that out of the way, thanks again for joining us. We'll see you all next time.